Good morning, everyone.
Oops, I gotta use this one. Oh yeah, this is supposed to be.
Okay. I don't know if you can hear me or not, but I would like to invite you to St. Patrick's Fallowfield for our celebration of life today. We're going to sing a few prelude hymns, and I invite you to join in all of the singing today. We're singing parish. The numbers are posted on either side, and we're going to begin with number 497. All of these songs are in your soft cover books. Sorry, it's the soft cover books. And I know we don't have a whole lot of books, but please share. And our first hymn is Come Follow Me, number 497. Our next prelude hymn is one you're probably more familiar with, How Great Thou Art, number 430, How Great Thou Art.
Sit around.
Please join in singing our opening hymn, Amazing Grace, number 449. Please stand.
Gentlemen, good afternoon and welcome to St. Patrick Church as we come together, family and friends from near and far, to pay our respects and to pray our goodbye. Danielle has gone to her rest in Christ, and we have gathered together to commend her soul to the love and mercy of God by our prayer and by our sharing in this time of remembrance and farewell. I invite you, please, to be seated as we now listen to words of remembrance and farewell that Tia will share with us at this time.
Good afternoon. My name is Tia Allard. Today, I'm standing in front of you, dear family and friends, reading these words with deep sadness in my heart to pay tribute to one of the most special people we know, Danielle. On behalf of the Chatelain and French families, I want to thank you all for being here and joining us in celebrating her life. Danielle Alexandra Chatelain was born on August 25, 1988 at the Ottawa Civic Hospital and passed away there on January 5, 2023 at 34 years young. Born by the very young parents, Elizabeth and Paul Chatelain, she was immediately nicknamed their Chickie. She was one of the first babies born, which set the trend of parenting with her coworkers and friends. Special times were spent with her grandparents, such as visits to the log farm, Beaver Pond, the Chatelain Cottage, and of course, accompanying Nanny to the Kanata Public Library where she volunteered. Danielle's greatest gift of all was the birth of her baby brother, Jeffrey, on July 31st, 1991, just shy of age 3. This was the turning point in her life. Although she couldn't pronounce Jeffrey and could only call him Juby, a name he still lives by today. The two of them were inseparable. She was referred to as Little Mama by many, and what a proud big sister she was. When Juby was still in diapers, she would parade him around in her toy stroller and show off her baby. She loved him and still loves him so much. She has certainly passed down that special big sister, little brother bond to her two children, Amelia and Bodie. Her mother recounts that growing up, Danielle was the most stubborn, defiant, willful child she'd ever met. Whatever the circumstance, she changed the dynamic in every room she walked in, like a meteor arriving. She gave 110% into everything she's ever tried. At age 4, Danny started ballet and would get dressed as soon as she got home from morning kindergarten. At 7, she was offered a spot in the enriched class, to which she said, nope, she was done with ballet and moving on to gymnastics. During her first gymnastics meet, she announced she was going to get a medal. Although her mom gently explained that it doesn't quite work that way, Danielle got not one, but 3 medals. Eventually, as gymnastics practices became more demanding, Danielle and her friend Erin Lackey decided they wanted to try a summer program of Irish dancing. Next thing you know, her parents were buying her wigs, dresses, shoes upon shoes, and spending all of their weekends at Feshes, Irish dancing competitions. Did the injured Achilles slow her down? No. Did she manage to break her foot while doing a butterfly jump in the middle of a competition? Yes. This was a blessing in disguise, as she couldn't do many activities with her complicated fracture, which led her into swimming. Danielle blew through all of her levels, eventually becoming a lifeguard, and started working for the city, where she still worked until the day she passed. Her friend and fellow lifeguard, Jacqueline, shared a memory she had of Danielle's compassion and dedication to her work. As a lifeguard, you're trained to jump in and save lives. But it was Danny's heart that compelled her to protect and save anyone in need at any time. They were together on the day she saved a homeless man. As others walked past, disregarding the situation, Danny saw him as a human in need of help. She stayed by his side until the paramedics arrived and took over, a testament of her kindness and willingness to help others. At another point in time, Danny was working at the Jack Purcell Pool on Elgin. A group of high school students living with disabilities would come in every week, and being with them was the highlight of her day. It was in fact one of their teachers who approached Danielle and encouraged her to apply to the DSW program to become a developmental service worker. While this field of work can be extremely demanding, she pursued this avenue and became an incredible healthcare provider, always patient and graceful with her clients, and upholding impeccable work ethic. Carol, a client that Danielle cared for before Bodie was born, became one of her most cherished friends. Although Carol eventually passed in February of 2021 due to her terminal illness, I have no doubt that the two of them are laughing together again. So I don't think I can go any further with talking about Danielle's life without bringing Curtis into the picture. The love of her life, quite literally how his name was saved in her phone, her best friend and partner. Although their love story officially began around 2014, they were no strangers to one another, having gone to the same schools for all of their lives and having many of the same friends. Anyone who knows them knows how perfectly their personalities complemented each other, despite being different. They were inseparable, and even more so when they had their kids. Spending time as a family was their top priority, and there was no shortage of adventures. They loved bringing the kids skating, whether it was at Young's Pond in Kanata or on the canal with Tom and Rachel, visiting the Toronto and Granby zoos, going for walks and drives to see all of the best Christmas lights around town, spending quality time with loved ones, especially fun visits with Uncle Gio each time he came to visit, and countless hours spent outside in nature. Speaking of adventures, I thought you'd like to know a little story about Curtis and Danny and their life-changing trip to Jamaica. Picture this. It's February 2015, and Danny is getting ready to leave for vacation, which meant getting a new passport because she had lost hers. When the two of them landed in Jamaica, she realized she had brought her old passport, the one that she had lost, and left her brand new one back at home. She kicked off the first few hours of vacation in a detention cell in the airport until the Canadian embassy could confirm her citizenship and she was finally free to go. Now, remember how I said it was a life-changing trip? Well, I meant it. A short 8.5 months after their vacation, they welcomed their new roommate into the home, exactly as Danny put it. And spoiler alert, that roommate was Amelia. We all have our fond memories of Danny, be it from her childhood, adolescence, or later in her adult years. What her brother cherished the most was how complete she was as a big sister. Everything you would want in a big sister, always there for you any time of day, always the person you want to talk to when you have a problem. Really just that one person in your life you go to for anything. We all have one, and she was his. She was protective and wouldn't let anything happen to him, no matter who it was that was picking on him. She was the great protector. She then carried those duties on to Curtis and started a family. She was fearless, caring, and compassionate as a mom. A fun mom who knew how to be the life of the party. She always brought her contagious smile, laughter, and of course, the inside scoop. Some of her closest mom friends from the neighborhood who would see her in her element every single day have said they didn't think Danielle took a day off from being a mom in all of her 7 years. Everything she did was for her kids. They were her greatest joy in life, and she was the most extraordinary mother. She was a strong voice not only for her kids or family, but for her close friends as well. You knew you were safe to be yourself in her presence. Danielle easily made friends anywhere she went, through grade school, while going to college and university, playgroups in Kanata, chatting with parents at school pickups or drop-offs, meeting new moms at the park. Many of those friends are here with us today and have shared some of their fondest memories of Danielle. Jess, Amelia's godmother, says, "I will always remember our endless Chemo sleepovers, crawling our way to class after late nights at the horse, and our weekly brunch, or better yet, happy hour at Summer Haze, where we exchanged creepy stories about Mr. Rodney. Best of all, I'll remember the day you had the brilliant idea of introducing me to your high school guy friends, where I met my now husband, Doug. Our lives would be very different if it weren't for you. I'm so lucky to have been blessed with your friendship, and I'll always be your Messica." Erica and Kate, two of her very good friends from university, remember Danielle, and I quote, "As the girl with the raincoat tied around your face, you came to our residence and never left, and for that we are grateful because you were always meant to be our home. To know you was to love you." And this couldn't be truer. Danielle had this amazing wit about her that completely changed your mood if you were having a bad day. She was able to find humor in everything and had the rare ability to laugh at herself. And she really was the funniest person I knew. Danielle was my best friend for several years, but compared to how long most of you knew her, it was just a short moment in time. We first met about 9 years ago. She was dating Curtis, and because my husband, Trevor, was a close friend of Kurt's, we had all been at the same house party together. It wasn't until Amelia was born and Trevor and I had moved back to Canada from living downtown that we really became close friends. When Amelia was about 12 months old, we found out we were expecting a little baby girl. I was pregnant for maybe 2 minutes before my phone started blowing up with text messages from Danny. My husband, in his excitement, or perhaps shock, had let the news slip to Curtis, and next thing I knew, Danny was at my house with a postpartum care package, including pads, stool softeners, stretch mark cream, prenatal vitamins, and of course, bags full of her maternity clothes. There wasn't a single piece of maternity clothing that the two of us didn't share between our next two pregnancies. Never mind all the clothes swapped back and forth between the kids. 2 years later, when my son was born, there was no doubt in my mind that Danny would be his godmother. That was a given, but the real honor was, and will always be, that Danny and Curtis asked me to be Bodie's. So to my Bodie and my Amelia, I promise to teach you all of the things your mom would want you to learn, and I will always be there for you, no matter what you need. Your mom is so proud of you both. Together, her and I navigated all of the ups and downs of motherhood, growing our families, the demands, the stressors, the fears, the sleepless nights. Yet the kids would never know it because all they felt when they were together was love, safety, and comfort. Being with each other, making core memories, building a connection so strong that it went far beyond friendship, we became family. Our kids became each other's cousins, and our larger families became more closely intertwined. This past year, I think Paul and Lise met us with the kids at every possible farm in Ottawa, probably twice, and Danny would be the first to know when my mom would be visiting from Toronto so we could get together while she was here. Although we never took it for granted, I not only share your grief and mourn the loss of our beautiful Danny, but mourn the loss of a day-to-day life that will never be the same. The texts, phone calls, walks, playdates at the park, trips to Ellen and Perry's cottage in Barry's Bay, sledding at the hills, sharing pictures on Mother's Day, Canada Days at the KRC, girls' nights, movie nights, holidays, birthdays, they will all be missing the one person that made them so memorable. Danielle had this tremendous ability to be present in so many people's lives. Look around this room. We are all touched by her, and that's why we are here today. Her brother's words speak for all of us when he says just how incredibly grateful he is for her immeasurable impact on his life. She was loving and honest, something I deeply admired about her. She was a mighty force to be reckoned with. And although we don't look forward to it, we'll make sure to carry these memories and values that she's taught us as we begin to navigate a life without her. And how lucky are we to have had someone that makes saying goodbye this unbearably hard to do. So Danny, on behalf of your family and friends, I thank you. Thank you for your passion, for your nurturing and care of others, for your generosity and selflessness even at the end of your life, for your patience and understanding, for your faith, your deep devotion to your family, and for your unconditional acceptance and love. All that we love deeply becomes a part of us. Your memory lives on, especially through your incredible children and with all of us here today. The truth is, a great soul serves everyone all the time. It never dies. It brings us together again and again. So there are no goodbyes for us. Wherever you are, you will always be in our hearts. Danielle, You will be deeply missed by everyone, and we will love you forever. We hope you get the chance to see Princess Diana again, as you did in 1989, handing her roses from the same building you left us. May God be with you till we meet again. And as we contemplate this tremendous loss, let's bear in mind everything that Danielle's taught us. Unconditional acceptance of others, optimism at every crossroads, to protect and cherish the ones we love and those who need a little extra love. I will leave you with one last quote. Danielle had this tattooed on her side, and it brings me peace when I think about its meaning, especially now. Taken from Winnie the Pooh, Christopher Robin says, "If ever there's a tomorrow when we're not together, there's something you must remember. You're braver than you believe, and stronger than you seem, and smarter than you think. But the most important thing is, even if we ever part, I'll always be with you."
Dear friends, I invite you please to stand as we begin our time of prayer and celebration. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God our Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, as we gather in prayer, let us commend Danielle's soul to the Lord, that the Lord may embrace her in peace and raise her up on the last day. Brothers and sisters, let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Danielle, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
I invite you please to be seated as Isabel now shares with us the first reading.
I'm going to be reading from Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verses 1 to 11a, a time for everything. For everything there is a season, and a time for every matter under heaven, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to pluck up what is planted, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to break down and a time to build up, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to cast away stones and a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing, a time to seek and a time to lose, a time to keep and a time to cast away, a time to tear and a time to sow, a time to keep silence and a time to speak, a time to love and a time to hate, a time for war and a time for peace. What gain has the worker from his toil? I have seen the business that God has given to the children of man to be busy with. He has made everything beautiful in its time.
Thank you. Now our music ministry will lead us in our responsorial psalm.
Please join us in your soft cover books, number 440.
You who dwell in the shelter of
I invite you please to stand for the gospel.
Oh,
reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go and prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again, and I will take you to myself, so that where I am, you may be also. You know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said to him, "Lord, we don't know where you're going. How can we know the way?" Jesus answered, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated. Today we are assembled in faith to commend Danielle's soul to the Lord. She who was loved in this life by the Lord has now been welcomed by him into eternal life. Our prayer is that her soul will rest in peace until that day when Christ will raise up from the earth all who have hoped in him for salvation. On this day of sadness and farewell, your hearts are heavy as you feel deeply the loss which Danielle's death has brought you. But our faith reminds us that while death is part of our human condition, we are also made for eternal life. This is what Solomon in the first reading was wrestling with: the cycles and seasons of life, the interaction between those experiences which bring us joy and sadness, that build us up and break us down, and those that mark beginnings and endings for us and for those we love. Danielle shared in her full but too short life in these experiences with you and with many others who are not able to be with us here today. Each of you carries in your mind and heart memories of the life you shared with Danielle and the ways in which she brought goodness and love into your lives. These memories now are treasured remembrances of Danielle, who is too soon gone from you. It was to the disciples on the night before he died that Jesus spoke the words proclaimed in the gospel: "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe still in me." Going to his death the next day, Jesus wanted the disciples and, through them, us to know that beyond this world with its joys and sorrows, there is a place to which we are welcomed when our journey under heaven is complete. Jesus calls this place his Father's house of many dwellings. It is also called the kingdom of heaven, and it is called paradise. Whatever we may call it, it is the inheritance of those who trust in the Lord, who hope in his promise of salvation, and who live his gospel of love and compassion for one another. Danielle, loving you and caring for you, giving of herself to those with whom she worked and those with whom she shared her life, knew the Lord and believed in these promises. On that future day, the day of resurrection, Danielle and all who sleep in Christ will be created anew in the likeness of Jesus' own resurrection. And in that new creation, we shall find our place in the house of many dwellings. There you, with Danielle, will know unending joy and peace. For in the light and peace of that eternal home, there will be no sorrow or sadness, and death will be no more. Amen. Dear brothers and sisters, I invite you please to stand as we offer now our prayers of intercession. Brothers and sisters, our Lord Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and is now seated at the right hand of the Father in his house of many dwellings. We are confident that God hears the voice of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, and we join our prayers to his, saying together, hear our prayer. In baptism, Danielle Alexandra received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead her over the waters of death. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Danielle was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome her into the halls of the heavenly banquet. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Those who trust in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Danielle's family and friends seek comfort and consolation, heal their pain, and dispel the darkness that comes from grief. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We are assembled in faith and confidence to pray for the repose of Danielle's soul. Strengthen our hope that we may live in the expectation of our place in your eternal home. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer, Jesus Christ, and the voices of your people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place in your eternal kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. I invite you please to be seated as the offerings are presented and the altar is prepared.
Please join us in singing Be Not Afraid, number 438.
Thank you.
invite you please to stand as we pray. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Danielle, we beseech your mercy that she who did not doubt your son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful Redeemer who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended, and when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. At this time, I invite those who are able to please kneel for the Eucharistic prayer, and for those for whom kneeling isn't possible or part of your religious custom, I invite you please to be seated and to bow your head. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Now I invite you to stand as together we acclaim the mystery of faith. As we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Marcel our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Danielle Alexandra, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who is united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all. We pray that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostle, St. Patrick, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. The Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. For those wishing to receive communion today, I invite you to approach by the center aisle and then to return to your pews by the side aisle. I invite you, please, to stand as we pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, your servant Danielle may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Danielle, and we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we will see Danielle again and enjoy her friendship. And although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in our faith in Jesus Christ. In baptism, Danielle Alexandra shared in the death and resurrection of Christ. We pray she be welcomed into the glory of eternal life. And as a reminder of her baptism, we bless now the urn with the water made holy by the prayer of the church. Brothers and sisters, let us pray. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend the soul of your servant Danielle in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon her in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with Danielle forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Are you speaking? I invite you, please, to be seated as Paul will share with us now a few words. Gentlemen.
Good afternoon. Thank you, Father Paul, the staff of St. Patrick's Parish, the choir, and everyone for such a wonderful service. Thank you, Isabel and Tia, for your reading and kind words. Danielle would be so proud. She would be. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank everyone on behalf of the Chatelain and French family, especially a lot of you who come from a far distance to be here. So thank you. In particular, I want to recognize exceptional care from our healthcare workers. We have a wonderful healthcare system in our country that really deserves a lot of credit. And there are many healthcare workers here today. So in particular, I want to thank the first responders, the City of Ottawa paramedics, Queensway Carleton Hospital ER team, and of course the 24/7 care provided by the University of Ottawa critical care team, comprised of wonderful physicians, nursing staff, nursing care coordinator, social worker, transplant coordinator, ward clerk, the clergy, housekeeping, volunteers at the main entrance, and even the staff who stocked the PPE equipment so we can see Danielle. A special thanks to the staff at the Trillium Gift of Life, who somehow helped us make a sad and tragic story or situation turn into something beautiful. I've learned a lot over the last couple of weeks, and I just want to share two things in particular. During the 30 hours before urgently driving to the emergency department at the Queensway Carleton Hospital, I was fortunate to have lunch with her the day before, before after her shift, FaceTimed her with Amelia and Bodie that evening, tried to make dinner plans the following day, which she responded, "Dad, I'm so sick, I just can't do it." We have that loving relationship in our family. Please stay close to your family and the loved ones, and always keep in touch with them. The last thing in conclusion I want to share to everybody here today, share with your loved ones your final wishes. And I don't mean to go out today and tomorrow get a will, but let somebody close to you know, what would you like, cremation versus burial, open or closed casket, which charity would you like people to donate? The list goes on. Go home, please, and jot that down on a sticky note somewhere. Promise me. We did this on the fly, but we know Danielle, and it's exactly how she wanted. And I'm sure she would say, "Everyone, you nailed it." Thank you.
We stand one more time. And I know Paul just invited you to go home and make a list. However, before you go home, there is a reception in our parish hall to which you are all invited, so please make your way there, and you can continue as family and friends to share stories of love and friendship that you had with Danielle. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the blessing of Almighty God come upon you today and remain with you always, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. Dear friends, may every mark of affection and every gesture of friendship that you give to others be a sign of God's peace for you. And may you go in peace to love and serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
As we go forth, let us sing, O Loving God, number 688. 688.